I don't know how long we were away, you know, in the kampung. After that, when everything settled down, we came back. So we came back to Parit Buntar, that house. Remember, you all remember a bit lah. That Simpang Tiga house lah is on the way to Taiping. That is Bidong house. The Chinese people bought it and then converted. At the moment, it is a temple, Chinese temple there. The last time we went to visit one time at Uncle Jeffrey, yeah, it was still the old bungalow. I remember I took some pictures of it, you know. But where are the pictures? Bidong was, I don't know how my mother acquired that is like our green town house, you know, that kind of a house, all wooden, and then a long corridor and the kitchen, like our green town house lah. And then, but the green town house, the wall is lower, isn't it? This one is, the wall is very tall. Underneath the house, you can walk and then we can play, but it's all dirt below the house. So the kitchen is a separate unit, like just like our green town houses. Outhouse, everything is all outside. Your bathroom, everything. Because we didn't have tap water. It was a big well in an enclosure, you know, like a big bathroom. So we have to go out to get the water and all that. That my grandparents were there, like my grandfather, my grandmother, Auntie Irene, and my myself, and Uncle Jeffrey was a little baby, maybe 1 year old or what. Very sickly fellow always. My mother had a lot of property, you know, those days when she was young. She had houses. Finally, she had some rubber estate, but that one, finally, Uncle Jeffrey sold it when my mother was very sick after I got married and came out. So we moved back to Parit Buntar, and then we were there. And then after that, you know, the English school is ACS. Now it's Methodist school already. It was ACS. They had ACS primary and they had ACS secondary. So we enrolled in the primary school because in Parit Buntar, that house next door to our house, he is a teacher in the school. His name is John Santhanasamy, I remember. So through him, we enrolled and we went back to school. And from there, from primary school, after that, secondary school, we were there. And then during the school thing, I played hockey for the school. And then those days, all the government officers, all the head of the officers, all the Europeans, there was education department was, I remember, Mr. Hicks. And then after that, then office, all the immigration, all the police thing, all were Europeans, you know. So their wives accompany them in Malaysia. But they had a club in Parit Buntar. It's a big field and there's a club there. They all belong to the club, but they must have activities. So they started to, you know, have a hockey team lah. That time Daddy was one of the coaches also, Daddy and some others. And then in school, because we were playing for the school team, we had our school, one school master lah. He was our coach. So we thought, why we are playing for the school since these people are not enough to make a team, you know. So we joined them like after school, not during the school period or what lah. School period, we have our practices in the evening. Certain days we have must go for the practice, hockey practice, sport practice and all that. So that is the time is connected with the school. Other, when it's not connected with the school, we practice and play with all the ladies. So that was how my... And then because Daddy was our coach, that's how I met him. And then I used to go to Sunday school. And then from there, I went to church, but I was not baptized yet. It's a Methodist church, connected with ACS, but it wasn't a church. The school, every Sunday, the primary school had a small hall and we had our service there. No Methodist church at all in Parit Buntar. There was like a St. John's church, but no, it doesn't belong to the Methodist. So that all the St. John's people went there. We went to this primary school building. Every Sunday they have service. And we didn't have a proper pastor. So our school headmaster, Fred David, he was a temporary preacher. Every Sunday he will preach. And then we had our Sunday school. We attended Sunday school and we attended the church. And that's how I grew up. Until after that, met Daddy and then he decided to get married. I was still very young, you know. I was about 18 years old. Bidong, we had to move to Parit Buntar because I also don't know for what reason. We're not going to school anymore. We have to be in Parit Buntar. My mother was here. My father was in Parit Buntar. So we moved to Parit Buntar.
Wait a minute. Yeah, during the war, your father disappeared.
Yeah, when the Japanese invaded, mother and father were in Parit Buntar. We were all, because we stay in Bidong, because we were going to school. After that, my mother said, no point you all staying so far away, better come back to Parit Buntar. So brought us all to Parit Buntar, and we stayed and we live in Parit Buntar.
Who was taking care of you in Bidu?
We were staying with my grandparents.
Like, oh, grandparents.
All the while, grandpa and grandma only brought us up, you know. I was never growing up with my mother. Only as a baby, maybe I was with her. After that, we were growing up with our grandparents and we went to school with the care from our grandparents. Only school holiday, like during holiday time or no school or what, and then my mother will take us for a holiday to Penang or where for a while. And after we go back to Bidong. That time was before the war. So after the war, no more Bidong already. No more. You know, my mother managed to sell the house, or later only she sold the house or what. I don't know about that already because I was young then.
When you moved down, that means your grandparents also moved
yes,
down?
Yes, la, all I have to come down. In Parit Buntar already. No more Bidong already. No more going back there. It's after the... And then the Japanese also never lasted. But how many years only after the surrender? And we stayed on in Parit Buntar. That was it. My father never came back.
What age were you when you moved to Parit Buntar?
I was still under 10 years old. And I don't know actually how old was I. But when we started going to school, maybe I was 12 years old. What? I don't know. During the war days, no school. What? How many years? Huh? So we were at home. And then my mother, because she got lots of Indian friends. I used to follow her to this Indian house in Simpang Tiga, further down from my house. They are quite rich people. They had us like a tuition lady to come and give the children tuition. So I used to join them. Just homeschool for a while only, before the proper school opened. After that, when everything settled down and Japanese surrendered and the proper school reopened, we registered with a proper teacher. We went back to school and studied. Until after that, I got married. I was staying with your party for, I think, 9 months. And then daddy from Parit Buntar Education Department, he got immediate transfer to Ipoh. They say report Ipoh Education Department on what date, certain date they gave him. So we left for Ipoh at that time. I didn't know anybody in Ipoh, and that time it was during the height of the communist party. Used to frighten me, you'll be alone. The communists are all around, all the Chinese were all you know. I was really very, very scared because I had no friends, I had no neighbors new in Ipoh. So we were staying in Greentown, started from there. No house at all because he had a colleague in the education department, one Malay guy. He was given this big house in Greentown. You know, our Greentown, all the government houses are all with 2 big rooms and 2 bathrooms and a kitchen all down there. He had a house like that. But his family, because they were all in Kuala Kangsar, children all studying, so the wife said, no, let the children study in Kuala Kangsar. You go to Ipoh and work and you come back. So he told daddy, I got a spare room. If you want, you can bring your wife. That's how I got to come to Ipoh. If daddy didn't get a place to stay, I won't be in Ipoh yet. So we stayed there for a while in Greentown, that house there, with that Malay guy. He didn't have to pay rent because it was the government quarters only. And then in the education department, daddy befriended this Eurasian guy Frederick Nicholas. And then he and his mother and his siblings also were living in Greentown, somewhere near our area. Also not his own house, you know. He also tumpang like this. Like somebody's, there were 5 of them in the family. Mother and the 5 children, you know. Imagine staying in somebody's house in Greentown. So daddy and him decided, why not we rent a house, we look for a house and rent. So that's how they found a house in Pasir Putih. It was a big, huge mining area, but no operation anymore. So this Chinaman, I think he owned part of the land or what. So he built, don't know how many houses, you know, in that mining land. So we managed to acquire one unit. It's like a terrace place. So we acquired and then we shared that house. The Nicholas's and myself, we took 1 room and they took the rest of the house, or 2 rooms and the rest. So we shared the rent and I stayed there till I was pregnant with you. After that, I don't know what happened. The Chinaman wanted back the house or what. I don't know whether his family was coming in or what. We had to move again. This time we went to a kampong. It's a Malay kampong in Pasir Putih itself, but it was a wooden house, kampong house. And then after that, I was there pregnant with you. So the Nicholas auntie told me all her children will go to school. She's a teacher, so she teaches English in one Chinese school. And then daddy and this Nicholas, all those days got no car, got no this, all cycle to work. And I'll be alone at home. I'll be alone. And she told me, you are in this condition, anything should happen, how will we know? Those days there were no telephone, there was nothing, you know. Nobody had a phone in the house, anything. Daddy will go in the morning and then come back in the evening, and these people also after school they'll be coming back and all that. So that's how daddy took me to Parit Buntar to have you. That one, after I got married, after 10 months, daddy got transferred. Boxing Tata brought us. We didn't have furniture, nothing. Mattress and this thing all wrapped up in a my cooking utensils and basic thing. And a bag of clothes. That's how I came to Ipoh first. He brought us and left us in Greentown, that house. And he went back.
So when you went back to Parit Buntar again, took a train?
Of course, daddy took me by train. We went by train.